get every opportunity to try to make the team this coming year. It's ultimately on the player to ultimately deliver on that, right? So we'll wait and see how things play out. But it certainly sounds like both sides feel very good about this fit based on everything that I've been told. All right, time for a quick break. We're coming back with much more on the other. Let's get back to the kid here for a second because, you know, there had been so much hype and talk about where he would ultimately land or fall or dip to. And, you know, after all the fall sort of hubbub about him, he dipped, all right? But I'll tell you what, they got themselves a player. Where he goes, I like the organization he lands with. I think it's going to give him some time to marinate here properly, to develop and mature. And when he finally becomes a player ready for prime time in the National Hockey League, you mark my words, you're looking at a long career from this player. I really do believe that. I think he's going to stay, and he's going to stay for a long time. He's just going to need a little time, but I think they got an absolute steal where he slots in. Now, the understanding that we've got is that the kid was supposed to be heading down to the rink sometime today to kind of check out the new surroundings. This has got to be like the first day of school, Razor.
Guaranteed he would have gone early to go and take a look at the locker room. You walk in there for the first time, you can't believe your lifelong dreams are about to happen.
And when you're looking around, I'm assuming, you know, is he thinking the nameplate might be up there?
Oh, you're hoping, but, you know, yeah. He's going to learn that those trainers don't miss very often. The jersey's ready. Your name has never looked so good as when it's on top of your stall. But what I remember, James, is the excitement, the nervousness, how scared you were. And then you're like, I'm in an NHL room. I can't believe this. It is the very best of feelings that you can have till you step on the ice the first time.
sealed and delivered. Yes, the entry-level contract, better known technically as the ELC, yeah, you know me, is signed up. And now it's time to find out if he can live up to the hype. I think fans would love to see him make that jump to the opening night roster. Management would love to see it. And I know the kid has every intention of trying to crack it, too. All right, enjoy it. The honeymoon's almost over because it's time to shine. We'll find out in camp. All right, still to come here on the show, our conversation. the whole narrative and the expression being good in the room, right? You know, chemistry is important with a team. You know, how many times have we seen teams that are absolutely stacked with talent and they fall apart? Why? Because there was just a disconnect within the room. And I know with some reporters, some of the media members asking the kid, saying, hey, you know what, why? How do you endear yourself to teammates more? I don't know if there's ever really an answer. I mean, you can go out and, you know, try to be the best player you can be. That's one way to do it. You know, personally speaking, I think another great way to do it is buying everybody pizza. Because, you know who likes pizza? Everybody. Right? Everybody loves pizza. Let's go back to the phones here. Let's go to Brent. Brent is on line three. Hi, everybody. Welcome to the Music City, Nashville, Tennessee, along with Ray Ferraro. I'm James Cebulski. Ray, fans have been fired up for this one for a while. What are you looking forward to most here watching this one?
Well, goaltending is always important, and both teams have talked about the need for their goalie to be among their best players. But both of these teams lean on them heavily, and I would say the guy that plays the best is probably going to come out on top.
Opening face-off is just seconds away. Puck is dropped. We're underway where hope still springs eternal here in this exhibition play. Let's it fly and makes a save. Cutting to the front of the net. Oh, they do it again.
He's like a backboard in there. Bang, bang. The puck's off him twice. He makes two stops.
And and he takes a shot and makes the save. Here's a shot, and that's blocked. And now it's over to Novak. Errant pass, and they can't connect.
Scrum along the boards as they battle for the puck.
And they continue to apply pressure here. The Predators get a hold of it. The Coyotes played along the boards. And they won't connect on that one. The Predators have a hold of it in the defensive zone. Sends it across the ice.
Nice pass.
And they keep the pressure on. Kind of lost control for a second there, but regains possession. Turns it aside with the glove. James Cebulski, Ray Ferraro with you here in the early going of this period. We've still got zeros on the board. Right in front! Wide of the net!
You kick yourself in the tail after you miss a chance like this. Has to be on the net.
And that's off a stick. Move to the middle! Spectacular stop by the goaltender. How did he hang on to that?
Well, by being in the right position, James, he gets so tight to the shooter, there's nowhere for the puck to go. Bukaboom's able to recover, and he makes an unbelievable save here. That's a good chance.
Keller's depended upon greatly by his teammates. He's one of the stars of this team and needs to produce night in and night out. Ekholm's a great defender who can disrupt the opposition and even help his teammates generate chances from the back end. I'll be watching these two players to see if one of them can really shine for their team tonight. Guys, back to you.
Afanasyev's won the draw. And the stick breaks on the shot. The Predators scoop it up along the boards. Puck scooped up by Afanasyev. The Coyotes take possession here in the open ice. Manages to hang on. And that one's broken up. Great block there. Into the offensive zone. Sends it over with the stop. Prosvetov's going to slow things down and up for the whistle.
Well, you got to kill the play eventually. That way everyone can get reorganized.
The Predators win the faceoff.
Get on the board first. It really makes you feel like you can throw four or five into the net. Just look at this face-off play here on the replay, James. They're set, hoping they can win the draw, and when they do, the wheels are in motion that leads to this goal.
Nashville's got a jump in their step tonight as they strike early.
Well, that's going to help as well, James. Now you've got the lead. The guys feel good about themselves, and they can attack with the cushion of a one-goal lead.
Takes the feed. Great chance in front, and they can't connect. Enters the offensive zone from the left. Picked up along the boards by Borbieski. Receives the pass. And that's just out of reach. Icing's the call. You know the coaching staff's not going to love that one.
Well, I can think of about three plays he could have made other than that one, but hey, that's the way it goes. Now you need your centerman to win a draw.